last video we have completed all the points of the electric current and its effect. Am I right? So this is a new point which I am going to teach you for the electric current and its effect. What is actually the current? Already we have discussed what is the electric current. It is nothing but a flow of charge. Electric current is nothing but a flow of charge. Okay? Current is nothing but a flow of charge, or we can simply say the flow of electrons. Okay? So, flow of charge. Electric current is nothing but a flow of charge in a particular time. So, the current can be defined as a flow of charge per unit time. So, the charge is denoted by the capital Q and time is denoted by T. And current we can say I. So, I is equal to Q upon T. So, the flow of the charge, what is will be the unit of the flow of the charge? The flow of the charge, the unit of the charge is coulomb. While the unit, what is the SI unit of time? We can measure the time in second. So, the SI unit of the current will be coulomb per second. That is called as ampere. Okay? So, SI unit. The SI means what? International unit. The standard unit of electric current is ampere. How it is ampere? The flow of the charge per unit time. Current is nothing but flow of charge per unit time. It is denoted by the Q upon T. So, the unit of the current is ampere. And the instrument needed to measure the current is ammeter. What is the name of the instrument? It is called ammeter. See, this is an ammeter. Ammeter is used to measure the current. It is an electric instrument which helps to measure the current. In this, there is also one more point, that is voltage. Now, what is voltage? Can you just tell me what is a voltage? In electric current, one more point is there. We are saying that this much voltage of the current, that is 240 volt of the current is flowing in our house. In your electric bill, if you might have seen the electric bill, in that also the voltage is written. So, what is that? What is actually the voltage? Voltage is nothing but a current flow. The amount of current flows per unit time. That is called as a EMF. So, what is in the EMF? It is electromotive force. And to measure the electromotive force, we use the unit volt. And instrument needed to measure the voltage, that is called as a voltmeter. The instrument to measure the voltage, of the particular electric instrument, we use the instrument that is called as a voltmeter. Are you getting this? So, in our house, the amount of the current flow or the amount of the voltage in our house is 220 volt to 240 volt. The amount of current in our house, we use the 220 volt to 240 volt. Are you getting this? So, this is an instrument uses to measure the volt. We use the voltmeter. Are you getting this? In the next point, we have also discussed the different effects of the electric current. Yes, sir. Can you just recall which kind of the electric effect which we have learned? Heating effect, the magnetic effect, and one more is there, that is chemical effect. Heating effect works on the principle of the heating. Am I right? The amount of the heat produced by the electric appliances, that is called as a heating effect of electric current. Am I right? And magnetic effect, the when a particular material behaves like, when electric current passes through the particular object, it behaves like a magnet. That is called as a magnetic effect of electric current. Am I right? So these two things we have learned, and one more effect is there, that is chemical effect. What is meant by the chemical effect? Chemical effect is that when the chemicals are used, and a current is passed through this chemical, the chemicals are used to pass the current, to get an electricity. It is called as a chemical effect. Means first, for example, we use a different solution. In the last video, we have learned different types of the cell, dry cell. Do you remember? In Homi Baba also, we have learned the different types of the cell, dry cell, Lipschitz cell, nickel cadmium cell. We use the solutions are there. With the help of the chemicals, when we use the chemicals to get an current, that is called as a chemical effect. Are you getting? There are some causes of electricity which affects our whole electric appliances. For example, due to the short circuit and due to the overloading. Now, what is short circuit? Short circuit is nothing but when there are two wires. If you will see the wire properly, you can see the two wires. Yes or no? There are two wires. One wire is live wire and another is a neutral wire. When these two wires come in contact, or the touching of this two wire, and more supply of the electricity is produced, or the due to the heating of these two wires, when these two live wire and neutral wire comes in contact with each other, and still the current is passed, and when these two wires get heated, it can cause the fire. It can cause a short circuit. At that time, we can say due to the short circuit, we have got a fire. Yes or no? We have got a fire. What is actually how the short circuit is happened? When the live wire and neutral wire comes in a contact with each other, at that time the short circuit is caused. And the second cause of the electric current is due to the overloading. Now, what is overloading? Overloading means what? At a particular socket, if the number of wires are connected for the purpose, then what will happen? Due to the large amount of electricity consumed by that particular socket, it can cause the fire. So these are the two main types of causes for the electric current. That is due to the short circuit and due to the overloading. Are you getting this? So I hope you all have understood this. And the amount of current flows in our home is 220 volt to 240 volt. You have to just go through this video and write a notes on, prepare a notes on it. Thank you.